بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. الحمد لله رب العالمين. All praise is due to Allah, the Lord of the worlds. والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه أجمعين. And may the best of peace and blessings be upon our Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, household and companions, and everybody who follows in the righteous path until the day of judgment. أما بعد, to start, I greet you with the greeting of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And I do welcome you. This is your host, Amr Dabbur. Welcome to a new episode with the real stars, the stars, the Sahaba radwanullahi alayhim, the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the friends of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, our real stars, our real role models. Today, inshallah, we will talk about Zayd ibn Haritha radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Zayd ibn Haritha was taken as a captive and as a was sold as a slave and ended up being in Mecca, and he was being offered as a slave. Khadija radiyallahu anha, the wife of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the mother of the believers, got him, bought him, and offered him to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to serve him as a servant, to serve Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He stayed with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for so long until Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam received Islam, and Zayd radiyallahu anhu was the first of the mawali, was the first of the slaves to accept Islam, and he loved Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam so much, and you can imagine, he was so close to him, he is serving him, he is living with him, and he accepted Islam. His parents, he is from a noble family, from a good family, not a slave or anything, but he was taken as a captive, like I said. But his parents or his family got to know about his presence in Mecca, and they knew about his place, and they came, his father came along with his uncle, and they came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, started talking to him, telling him, you are Quraysh, you are the people of Mecca, you are the haram of Allah, you help those who are in need for help, if somebody is taken captive, you help freeing the captives and so on. They started praising the people of Haram and so on. They said, what are you up to? They said, this is Zayd, our son, and he was taken as a captive, and now we want to claim him back, we want to pay him, pay you to give us our son. He said, it's so simple and so easy, like you don't have to have all of these introductions. فَهَلَّ خَيْرٌ مِّن ذَلِكَ, shall I offer you something better than that? What if I call him right now and I give him the choice? If he wants to go with you, he's yours, you can take him. If he wants to stay with me, then I'm not going to prefer over his choice anything else. If somebody chooses me, I'm not going to choose. I'm going to definitely choose him. So they were so happy that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was so generous to offer them that. He called Zayd, and amazingly enough, subhanAllah, Zayd radiyallahu anhu, after being so long away from his parents, he chose to be with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam because he loved him so much, because he lived with him, because he saw how generous of a person, how kind of a person, how nice of a person, how noble of a person is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and who could be better than Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in anything. So he preferred to stay with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam than going with his parents, over going with his parents, with his father and his uncle, going back to his family. He preferred to stay as a slave with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam over going with his parents as a free person back to his family and so on, because anybody who would see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would love him. Anybody who would see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would be attached to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So from that day, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave him his freedom, and he emancipated him, he freed him, and he said, from that day on, since you choose me, you are now called Zayd ibn Muhammad, Zayd the son of Muhammad, not Zayd the son of Haritha, because you choose that, I'm going to give you my title, I'm going to give you my name, and you are Zayd ibn Muhammad. And he announced that in Mecca, that he will be even his official son, and he will inherit him, and they will exchange inheritance and everything. He's just dealing with him as a full son. But later on, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would reveal ayat from the Quran that we know Islam came gradually. So at this time, adoption in this sense was not prevented in Islam or prohibited in Islam. So later on, when the ayah came, udu'uhum li'aba'ihim, call them to their parents by the name of their parents, huwa aqsatu indallah, this is more just in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Adoption and giving your name to someone else who is not your son or child becomes or became prohibited. But obviously adopting somebody or taking care of somebody and even raising somebody with your kids and so on, with the rules according to the Islamic rules, is one of the best things that you can do in Islam, especially for orphans. But giving your names and applying all the rules of a full son, that only comes through the right channel, which is marriage and having legitimate children and so on, according to the rules of Islam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed these ayat to refute that. And there's another story involved with that, because Zayd will get married to Zaynab radiallahu anha, Zaynab bint Jahsh, which is a relative of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam from the noble family of Quraysh. And then later on he would divorce her, and then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam would get married to her, and everybody would say, how come you get married to the ex-wife of your son, so-called son? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this hukm, so to abrogate and to negate everything as far as this rule that was rampant and famous and known and practiced by the people of Quraysh about adoption, and setting up, Allah is setting up a new rule that this is gone. Zayd radiallahu anhu, yes, he is one of the closest people to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but he is not his son. He does not take the rule of the son of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was actually taking another beautiful title, which is, or nickname, which is Hibbu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or the beloved person by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the person who is beloved more than anyone else by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He loved him so much, and he lived with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Zayd also loved Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam so much. Year 8 after Hijrah comes, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would appoint a dispatch to go Ghazwat Mu'tah, to go. He would not lead the Ghazwa himself sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but he would appoint some leaders. The first leader that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam appointed was Zayd ibn Thabit. He is the Amir, or he is the leader of this group, and if he is killed, then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam appointed two more leaders, Ja'far and Abdullah ibn Rawaha. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was miraculously giving, subhanAllah, this kind of, as if it was a broadcast, live broadcast, and he was in Medina, and those people were hundreds of miles away from Medina, the Ghazwa, and the people in the dispatch. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling them that now Zayd ibn Thabit, or Zayd ibn Haritha, was killed. He was the Amir of this Ghazwa, and now he is killed. And he's telling them the details of what's going on hundreds of miles away, live, that he is getting that from Jibreel. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is making him getting this news. So Zayd ibn Haritha was killed, was martyred in this Ghazwa, and that marks the end of one of the greatest companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Zayd ibn Haritha, who is the father of Usama ibn Zayd, Hibbu Rasulullah wa ibn Hibb Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was another beloved person by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, just like his father, and inshallah we're going to talk about him later inshallah. But Zayd ibn Haritha is such a specific, beautiful, particular example of somebody who preferred to be with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to stay with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam over his own freedom, over his own family. This is, subhanAllah, something so unique to look at. We need to give preference to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even if he is not here physically, but his sunnah is there, his life is there, his guidelines is there, his deen is there, Islam is there, Quran is there. Would we compromise when it comes to how Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would do things versus how our community, our society, our norms, our cultures, how do we do things in our life? Or we give preference to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and how would he do things? This is Zayd ibn Haritha radiallahu anhu setting the example for us that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, number one, the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam comes over the love of anything. He wouldn't leave Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and go, even if he had to go to, he would go to his parents. He would rather stay with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam because of his love for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Radiallahu an Zayd ibn Haritha, may Allah be pleased with Zayd ibn Haritha. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with all the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah gather us with them in Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all follow in their footsteps until we meet with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on al-hawd, and we drink from his hand, and we all go to Jannah and be with them all. Allahumma ameen. Jazakumullahu khairan. See you next time, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.